I'm sorry. I wanna
take you somewhere. That's Charles Leclerc! And that is a very...
That crash is nasty, you know.
What is going on, guys? It is JJ here, back with a new video, and today we're going to take a look for the first time ever on the channel at the highlights, the history, the career so far, and the biggest asterisk mark on so far of the one and only Charles Leclerc. Obviously getting into F1 this year has been an absolute whirlwind. It's been an absolute highlight. I love every bit of the sport. I desperately tried this past weekend to stay awake or not go and do things so I could watch the Australian Grand Prix. Never worked out in my favor. Fell asleep for the qualifying and then was out being a degenerate for the actual race and was a little mad that I missed it. But it's one of those things now that I'm actually caring. Like, I'm actually caring for the sport. Like, before this, literally was just watching footy. I knew NASCAR, like F1 and IndyCar existed, but I was never super into the sport, like none of the driving sports. But I've always liked cars. And so it's been amazing to sort of find the premier sport with the premier athletes. Premier drivers with the pinnacle of motor engineering. It's been amazing. And to now see Charles Leclerc sort of reaching that pinnacle this year with what is going to probably go down as one of the smartest moves from Ferrari, focusing on their 2022 car instead of the 2021, letting Leclerc and Carlos Sainz sort of just do the best that they can with the 2021 car in hopes that the 2022 car would be light years ahead of everyone else. And they were correct. So far they were correct. But anyway, we're gonna take a look at the career of Charles Leclerc for Ferrari. I think this goes from 2019 and was released in 2021, so even they could not have foreseen what was going to happen so far this year. But let me know what you guys think about Charles Leclerc's season so far and what you guys are hoping or your aspirations for Ferrari. But yeah, let's get into the video. As well, guys, you can find the original video down in the description below. You should go take a look at it because he definitely put a lot of time and work into this.
Just see here, is he going to touch the inside? No, he's out the front.
I am stupid.
Oh.
I switch off everything.
That's going to be a nightmare. That's a wet course, though. Like, you can't have done much.
Oh, come on, Charles. I'm sorry. I want to
take you somewhere. That's Charles Leclerc! And that is a very...
That crash is nasty, you know. Jeez, my guy.
Accidents.
Yeah, he's probably pissed, as he should be.
Is he gonna go inside or outside? Which way is Verstappen gonna go here? DRS wide open, gaining on the Ferrari. Switches early, Verstappen. Late braking, Leclerc this time might just have to give way as he goes off the track. And when he comes back on,
and getting owned by probably his biggest rival. My man just got bullied. Verstappen bullied him there.
There's something strange with the engine.
Okay, copy that. We are checking it.
There's something strange with the engine.
Oh no. I hope not.
What's happening?
Leclerc's a sitting duck. On
another love. So Lewis Hamilton down towards the final corner takes the lead of the Bahrain Grand Prix.
No.
Are you telling me he lost a race to Lewis Hamilton in the final corner because of Ferrari's engine trouble? That hurts.
It's lights out and away we go. Leclerc gets away well. Hamilton and Bottas now jockeying for position. And Hamilton coming alongside Charles Leclerc with Bottas now with some free space. Sebastian Vettel behind him. Ricciardo on the outside of Hülkenberg. Leclerc goes into the first chicane ahead and just ahead as well. Hamilton now pulls out to have a go. Leclerc stays ahead by about a car length and a half. This is brilliant racing.
Very smart positioning of his car there from Charles Leclerc.
He's holding on.
He's going for it.
The music is just so sick too.
Grande they go. Into the Grande move. Lewis Hamilton towards the Della Rocha chicane. The car's on the inside. Hamilton goes onto the gravel and has to take to the escape runner. And he
dear life.
And Hamilton is going to have a go. Which way this time? Wanted to go around the outside. Has to switch to the inside. Leclerc is making it very difficult indeed.
Seconda subito, consecutivamente, sono in otto, e adesso diventano nove, il predestinato vince il Gran Premio d'Italia!
From that, that's honestly the music to this also makes it so sick. Seeing a Ferrari finally, I don't know how you guys do it.
You've done it.
And he did it holding off Lewis Hamilton the whole time. Like, that's such a gutsy race.
The Tifosi celebrates. What an epic race, and what a star of the future celebrating wildly in the present.
Dude, look at all the Ferrari fans over there. Jesus.
They have swapped round in the pits. It was all down to the work of the pit crew. And even better, they get out just ahead of Carlos Sainz. As well, he's gone wide. Has all the good work become undone as Verstappen tries to fight back and then sees Charles Leclerc swoop past it. Now he pulls out to go alongside the Ferrari. It's wheel to wheel. Down in the Brooklands, Leclerc is back out in front of Verstappen.
Verstappen wide again. He's now going to have to defend against Leclerc.
He's been doing all the attacking on Leclerc. Now
ooh, Leclerc! Put him in there. Running wide. Oh, that red was so good, though.
Around the outside of the village, he's going to go for it. And Charles Leclerc, that is absolutely epic. Charles Leclerc is going to be on pole for the first time ever.
Hamilton didn't do a personal best in any of the three sectors on that lap.
The young man at 21 years and 166 days becomes the second youngest pole sitter ever. And he goes even faster than he did before.
Dude, why is the music? Who? The video quality is so damn good. And it fits with. I mean, these highlights make me want to run through a brick wall. They make me want to go through a brick wall for Charles Leclerc in the Ferrari.
It's round of applause, and it's welcome to the pole position club for Charles Leclerc. Look how Leclerc is gaining on Vettel.
Passing Sebastian Vettel in the Ferrari.
Has he gone too deep? No! Just gets back onto the racing line.
Dude, that's so sick that they're with each other neck and neck.
Vettel will get the DRS down into turn four. This is a proper race. Nobody's yielding at all.
Cross the line. Leclerc's on provisional pole. Hamilton's now on the front row. Misses out by 5/100. Verstappen goes third. Charles Leclerc's going to be on pole unless Valtteri Bottas can stop him. And he can't. Bottas, fourth on the grid. Verstappen.
Look at this. So sick.
I wonder if he was a bit too close to the Mercedes. Verstappen crosses the line, stays fifth fastest. Charles Leclerc goes quicker. He's on provisional pole. Lewis Hamilton on the front row with it. Can Sebastian Vettel make it a lockout?
It's a Ferrari one too.
It's a Ferrari front row lockout. And it's lights out, away we go. Graced off of Albon, Sainz has stalled on the grid. Sebastian Vettel tucks it behind Charles Leclerc. Lewis Hamilton on the inside, trying to get it. Vettel, Kimi Räikkönen has been made contact with him. He's bouncing over the curb, as is Nico Hülkenberg back there with the Renault as well. Charles Leclerc leads them down through Eau Rouge from Hamilton.
Bro, it's far, isn't it? It's far.
Hamilton, now through the middle sector,
is
coming
down.
Oh, Hamilton's coming. Oh, Hamilton's crown. He's not going to be easily beaten, is he? He never gives up.
Ferrari came here with the advantage on paper. It's not been plain sailing on the asphalt, but Charles Leclerc can now see the checkered flag, and for the first time ever, Charles Leclerc wins a Formula One Grand Prix. Charles Leclerc wins the Belgian Grand Prix.
You know what? That's fair. That is fair.
manages to avoid it. The man who's been on pole the last two races gets to the line now, and Charles Leclerc has done it again.
So there was a, there so really was a time then. What is this, in 2020, 2021, where Ferrari were storming Vettel and Leclerc? What happened then? Because, I mean, if they're going better in pole than Hamilton and Bottas, the car had to have been at that level. Like, there's no way.
For Charles Leclerc, is it four poles in a row? It is four poles in a row for Charles Leclerc. Seven poles in his career for Charles Leclerc. What a special pole this would be as he comes to the line now, crosses it, and moves fastest overall.
Oh, okay. Bro, this video has been so sick. Honestly, it's made me, it really has made me actually want to go see more Charles Leclerc highlights. I need to see more race highlights. What is Charles Leclerc's best race outside of this year? Please let me know it down in the comments below. Let me know what you guys are thinking. This has been fun. Predestinato? I gotta learn my Italian. Yeah, it's Italian. Yeah, but thank you guys so much for watching. And peace.